Need to be careful here. Easy now. Something's not right.
Off limits. Ah, that burns! on!
To Alfheimer. Why is this a new realm entirely?
Sweat and blood. Birth. Turn this man from beast to earth.
Modron! Stay your blade! Die at my hand.
I should have known Kunon wouldn't have it in him to quarter you for the dogs.
It's a cold bitch who throws her lover to the wolves for her own crimes.
You understand so little. No matter. Let me enlighten you with the fury of the gods!
Thank you.
leave Gloucestershire in the hands of that Christian, and for what? Your name and some trade routes?
Do you doubt the power of your guards to sway the mind of a man? Teftar is no longer the sellout you believe him to be.
A man will lie to save his skin. When you are gone, he'll gut me and burn my people. The gods showed me this.
Kunan spoke of your vision. The Nordnir spin their fatal threats. But without your plan, his heart would remain unchanged.
Then I have no regrets. But I had a vision of you as well. One of a path that twists like the River Ouse.
The seer's spinnings twist limb and word alike. Prophecy is a river, and we are powerless to fight its clutches. She was fighting to protect her people. But she ground your name to dust. Sullied the honor of herself and her people. I cut my own path.
Lord, in his mercy. What sorcery happened here?
The High Priestess Modron tried to kill you.
Why? In God's name, I've done nothing to her.
She feared the Church would use you as God's hammer, so she convinced Kunan to have you killed. I killed Modron, but Kunan lives to burn in the Wicker Man.
Such a waste of life. The devil whispers into the ear of man. But we must ignore his voice.
Modron had a vision of you wiping out the pagans. And Gwynedd is Kunan's bastard. So he simply did it to protect his kin.
Love for one's child is a virtue. But wrath is a sin. How can one entangle with the other?
We all lose our heads when our legacy is threatened. Be that name, kingdom, or child. Now, what of the Witchling?
I'll see that she's cared for. She has no guilt in this.
I will not join your Church of Christ!
You won't have to.
fight?
I have returned. Gunnar, it's good to see a face I trust. Even your frightful mug. I thought this could be your shared saga, but it is time to leave. We have spent naught but a drink together.
Worry not, Eivor. You and I have many tales to tell yet. And our names ring out clear and with honor.
Yeah, a tale. A tale of Gloucester. Beautiful land, full of damned fools.
Ha! I will drink to that. You have my thanks.
Anything for you, old friend.
Then let us say our farewells to this wicker king. And then be on our way home.
Yes. Randvi will be eager to meet Richard. Richard and Gunnar have already gone ahead. I should join them.
What of Modron?
Dead and burned on a pyre, much like this one.
I didn't think. I hoped you would spare her at least. Grant.
Please don't do it! We can find something else, someone else!
Peace, dear heart. I will join the dirt that grows the trees and the barley, my body feeding the gods, worms, and even you. So I will be here. And a long, long time from now, when you're old and wrinkled like an apple, you will see me again.
Father, I thought I could be ready.
It is time.
Then this is yours.
This is your path, Tifter. No thorns and briars could keep you from it.
And you, Eivor, friend of Gloucestershire, you have lived up to your reputation.
I know you owe me less than nothing, but please, take care of them.
I take no pleasure in the suffering of others. You would know this if you had given me a chance.
Twenty years I have been your elderman. Now these old bones are ready for my last duty. I have worked alongside you, clearing fields, brewing drink, births and deaths. All growing and learning.
The Wicker Man is ready, O King. Your altar awaits.
I am honored to be your Harvest King. With this flame set, may our crops be plentiful and our winters brief.
Despite it all, he has the ending he prayed for.
Straight to the mouths of hungry gods.
Eivor, the honor is yours.
Praise King!
Bloody pagans!
Why does Kunan have to go?
He's saving us all, love.
Dear God, preserve Kunan's soul.
Thank you for your life, O King.
Gods, please bless our fields with this sacrifice.
In heaven, our mother who art in earth, please, please accept this offering. Take of me my flesh and bone and bless.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Ranji. Let's tell her the good news.
Is there a ceasefire among you?
A story from my youth. This one has no lesson to be learned or message to be gleaned. Often my father liked to take me on hunts in the forested lands east of Arvaldsnes. I loved these solitary times with him. I had never felt a beast myself. My father saw that this upset.
No reason.
I was only a boy, but I had the dreams of being a man. One winter, my father asked me to perform a bargaining ritual to the goddess Skadi to improve his bolster in snow sights. With glee warming my heart, I caught a hare and sacrificed it to the goddess, asking in exchange of skill and sight.
Can't raise the sail.
Run up the sail!
We hunted all day until night fell, and we slew no game. That night, around the fire, I was sullen. My sacrifice had not been heeded, yet seeing my sad face, my father only smiled. Had you been hunting, he said, you would have killed 6 fine deer. For Skadi hears only those who speak to her.
What are you doing?
Sail!
Big loot!
Catch the wind!
Sing, my ravens. We need an epic tale.
During my 19th winter, King Styrbjorn ordered the construction of a new longhouse. The splendid hall you now see at Thornburg. To build this longhouse, he employed the help of 20 men. I was among them, as was Fradi, the strongest and stoutest man I had ever seen. He set about felling trees and hewing wood for timber. Fradi was the fastest of us, dropping 41 trees in only 2 days. On the third day, a spindly man called Gnar was near upon felling his first tree. He had hacked it all the way around like some mad animal. When the tree fell, it did so in a direction he had not wished. Straight down upon Fradi. Gnar called out, but it was too late. Fradi had only enough time to turn and face the doom bearing down upon him. With that, he raised his arms to embrace the timber hammer. The force of the trees falling drove Fradi deep into the snowbank, yet his arms never let go. He held that angry trunk as a lover. Like hounds, we scooped at the snow to reach him. We found Fradi 10 feet down, alive but in pain, still bearing the tree upon his shoulder.
Let the snow
thanks for stopping.
Like hounds, we scooped at the snow to reach him. We found Fradi 10 feet down, alive but in pain, still bearing the tree upon his shoulder. excellent sailor who could pilot a longship entirely on his own. This is why King Sigvaldi kept him around. Unar was a cruel, anxious, and humorless man. He was one of the most unlikable people I have ever known. One year, I recall he had invited some girls from the Yngling clan to dine with us. As we were serving ale, we came to find that we had none left. It so happened that the ale had run out just before reaching Unar's hall. This raised in him a word storm, and he accused Sigvaldi of treachery. Every man in the Longhouse jeered at Unar for raising such a fuss. This made Unar angrier than before. He stormed out. A short time later, we heard him yelling through the door of the hall. I set this great wall upon the men of Yngling for their dishonor! We looked outside and saw that Unar severed one of the heads of the Yngling's horses and stuck it upon a hazel branch. When he saw us gathering at the door, the Yngling carls among us, Unar panicked and ran. He was not seen for many months.
Dock the ship here. To go. See you soon. The Wolfka! So glad to see you.
My love.
I can hardly begin to describe what happened in Gloucestershire. I think you will learn soon enough.
But we are allied with them.
Yes. For all our pains. I want to see the Alliance map. Tell me about Jorvik. Hytham says there are three more targets there.
If that is true, you are in luck. Our old friends Jor and Ljuvina have made their homes in Jorvik. Both had status and influence in Norway, so they may have valuable insights into the city's politics.
That would make my work easier.
What say you, then?
I I will go now. Do you know where I might find Hjor and Lufina?
When entering a new city, it is best to ask around the ports. The people there know more than the average peasant.
Ragnarsson has come. He claims to have some business with you.
Uber Ragnarsson, you are a long way from your king's side.
Eivor. Yes, a long stroll through the hills and fields of Mercia. Also, I could thank you.
Thank me?
For sending my brother to his just reward. In spite of the harm he caused you and everyone around you, I could not keep him in line in this life. But I have no doubt the old father will put him to good use in the next.
A darkness followed your brother. One I am not sure he understood. But as you say, he is now where he belongs.
He is. And as a show of my thanks, I came to offer you a gift. A token of my respect.
Thank you.
Put it to good use, Wolfkist. And may we meet again soon. On a battlefield, if the fates are kind.
I should meet this abbess, Wolfhilda.
It is not that complicated.
You do not appreciate the subtleties of a cutting fly. cutting flight. That is why you misunderstand.
Nice to see Sigurd back where he belongs.
What have you got for me today?
Is that what you want? All my pieces are good, but that one's very good. This will serve you well. Like the looks of that one? I can get you that one easy. There it is. Now you can take on anything. You are looking powerful.
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Until next we meet.
Go!
Thank you.
To the Swan Road! More!
Sigurd!
Let's have a song.
Up we raise our shining blades. Like wolf teeth they brightly glitter. Now the time for bravery calls us.
In my youth I remember hearing the story of Kulda. Here's young woman whose father forbade her from swordplay and raids. Kulda had skills to match or surpass any man in the clan. And so it was that her beloved Garpi asked her aboard his ship. Once again, Kulda's father forbade her to leave, calling her soft and weak and fragile. Kulda ignored these insults and left. For a full spring, Kulda and Garpi
can't break
run up the sail!
Raiding and plundering and taking much silver and riches. Then, in the early weeks of summer, a passing ship gave Kulda the news that her mother had died suddenly. Kulda was grief-stricken. Kulda returned quickly home, only to find her mother there, alive and standing quietly beside her father. Kulda was confused. Kulda's father spoke with a sour voice. I sent the tale of your mother's death, for you were insolent. But now you are home, where you must stay. Hearing these words, Kulda pulsed hot with rage. She slew her father and fled back to her ship, then set swift sail for the horizon.
This must be Jorvik. The Order of Ancients lurk in its streets and alleys. My old friends Hjor and Lufina live here. Hjor and Lufina settled near this harbor. Someone should know where to find them. My friend, could you help me find some of my people? I'm looking for Hjor and Lufina.
Hjor? I know him. Are you a friend?
I am.
Then you will get no help from me, or any of the other merchants for that matter. Now, if you don't mind.
Bitter. Has Hjor wronged him somehow? Little one, can you help me? I'm looking for some friends. Do the names Hjor and Lufina mean anything to you?
I think I know that name. A woman. She's from Bjarmiland.
Very smart.
She sounded funny, so I asked her once. Hope it wasn't rude of me. You want to speak to the Dotmaster, Grigory. I've seen him talking with her before.
My thanks.
And what about me? What about my wares?
You can have your wares back when you pay the dock. Move along now. We ran a clean dock in Jorvik.
You must be the dockmaster.
What gave it away?
Everyone hates you.
As I just explained to your friend there, if your wares have been seized, take it up with the council.
These merchants are not my friends, but I'm looking for some. Hjor, Lufina.
You know Hjor and Lufina? What business do you have with them?
Yes, I know them. Now you seem to know them too. Point me in the right direction.
In a manor surrounded by flowers. That's where Hjor and Lufina live. How about some coin for my trouble?
How about I cut out your tongue?
Forget I said anything.
A manor? Hjor and Lufina have done well for themselves.
He
keep your coin pouch close to you. There are pocket thieves around lately.
They can try.
I cannot wait for the Yuletide feast. Snow, wine, food. It is truly the best time of the year.
Have you gotten gifts for your family yet?
Crate of mine taken this week, and with no explanation.
Rules are rules, but I wish they would tell us why.
This is their home. Ransacked. And this body, it's not your Olufna. Scattered scrolls. The thief was looking for something. There was a struggle here. Looks like it continued outside. Blood, but no body. Which way did they go?
It's me, Lufina. It's Eivor.
Eivor? What? Who sent you? Are you with them?
Breathe, Lufina. You're rattled. You know me. I am a friend.
Are you? You show up here like this. These people tried to kill me.
Cast your suspicion or be ready to kill me, because I will not raise my weapon against you.
I am sorry, Eivor. I did not mean to doubt you. It has been a tense few weeks.
Who were they? Why were they after you?
They were after this. I do not know what it is, but these men were ready to kill me for it.
A poor fellow soldier of Christ.
You know him?
I've seen a letter like this before, in London. This city is in great danger. Where's Hjor?
At the Royal Hall. I will take you there. Pull up your hood. We may not be safe just yet. This way.
They are still looking for me.
Hide low. We can slip past them.
I've gotten far. Look around.
Let's go.
Have you seen a Bajarmian woman? Answer well if you know what's good for you.
I haven't seen her, I swear. Did you hear something? Keep an eye out.
Þeir finnist ígjú her í Nordanlands, en þegar þú sigir Frakkaland ferða að Glíður að sjá þig.
Glíður að við mætum.
Þinn gammal Kristpetur, hann eigi dauður enda?
Look, over there. Is that her?
More of them. Just there.
Keep your head down.
Hey! Get back here, Vato!
You used that?
I think it is safe now.
Call it fate. I had hoped our paths would cross again. I imagined a cavalry.
We fled one problem only to find ourselves embroiled in another, while King Richier is preoccupied with the money shortage. Has been imposed on will.
One more attack.
Yes and no. They are bandits, but someone is controlling them.
Look no further than the names in that letter. Killing them is the reason I'm here.
But they are coded. They could belong to anyone.
The sludge in the streets often drips from the gutters of the halls. When in doubt, look to those in power.
You mean the council? Hjor is on the council.
That works in our favor. Someone we can trust to find the answers we seek.
Yes, we are nearly there.
Out of the shadows now. I do not see any others. Let's keep moving.
This way. There's Hjor! Hjor! Look who has come!
It pleases me to see you, old friend. All are welcome here in Jorvik.
It's good to find you well, Hjor. Both of you.
What are you doing here? You have not come all this way for the Yuletide.
I've come to warn you, old warrior, about a rut in your city. Three figures, corrupt and dangerous. We should work together to bring them into the light and kill them before they come to power.
However I may help, I am ready.
Slow yourselves. Eivor, we cannot just go running around the city, poking and prodding and killing at will.
They nearly did me, Yor.
What?
These people sent the Red Hand after her, ready to shed blood in your streets to keep themselves a secret. But they failed.
This is the letter that was sent to our home. The Needle, the Firebrand, the Vault.
They belong to a group called the Order of Ancients. These are their assumed names. Our leads.
Listen to him, Yor. He has dealt with their kind before.
Corruption has seeped its way into Jorvik. But King Rhysi's hands are full, which means my hands are full. Counsel on this matter will fall on deaf ears.
I do not want his counsel. All I have told you stays between the three of us. But you should introduce me to the king. I will need to align with him if we are to go about this freely.
Winning this war, we should be scraping together every ounce of silver to procure food for our men.
Understood, dear Faravid, but we also have a responsibility to our townspeople. The Yuletide must go on.
Enough. The more you argue, the more my head hurts. Hjor, I was not aware we had company, the likes of which I did not approve.
Is this how you greet all the strangers who walk through your doors? Or just those who mean to help?
Forgive me, Lord. This is...
Eivor of the Raven Clan. Don't bother. I know well who you are, Rhysi. You have a problem in Jorvik.
Yes, I'm looking at it.
A problem that nearly got my friend killed. Lufina was attacked by the Red Hand. They raided her home, destroyed her property, and chased her through the streets.
Those bloody scoundrels again!
She survived. But the Red Hand has been a growing problem here of late.
And what is your stake in this? You some sort of wandering mercenary?
No. This is Sigurd Jarl's Drenger. Took our old camp by the River Nene, as I hear it. I am Faravid, war chief to Halfdan Ragnarsson, and this well-fed wastrel is Audun, High Reeve of Jorvik.
I have seen rebel groups like this before. They sit and wait, and the moment you lower your guard, they spring up like weeds. If left alone, they will take Jorvik out from under you. Not what you want. Not what Halfdan wants.
Oh, dear.
What do you want?
Tell me what you know about the Red Hand, and I will rid your city of them. You can go about your affairs.
They've been sticking their hands in coffers around the city, targeting nobles, merchants, and anyone else they can throttle.
And they are growing, as you said. I would rather not be worrying about them come Yuletide.
This is not something we can afford to ignore. If we do not have the means to deal with the Red Hand, we should let Eivor.
Do what you can, but do it quietly. I do not want the public alarmed. Hjor, send funds to procure food and ale for Faravid's men. And make sure there's enough left over for the feast.
But it's as I said. We don't have...
Find it. I have spoken.
Tells me to find more silver. Where? In a dragon's hoard? Come, I will take you back to Lufina. She will know where to begin. I cannot tell if that went the way you had hoped.
It went well enough. Rhysi will stay out of my way. No one can argue the Red Hand must be dealt with. Speak a word of this to no one. The circle of trust must stay between the three of us.
You will forgive me for stepping away. I grow weary of those pissing contests.
My love, I am sorry for what happened. I should have been there.
Nonsense. You have your duties to fulfill. Besides, a few bandits is hardly something to worry over.
I am only glad you were not harmed. Eivor, I will be around if you need me.
Once you catch the tail, you do not let go.
Old habits die with the struggle.
Yor has changed. Softened.
Politics. It takes the Norse out of a Norse.
I'm happy for him. And you as well. You have made something of yourselves here.
Perhaps.
What do you have there?
Christian texts. The Gospels. Ecclesiastes. The Revelation of John. The Red Hand steals all they can find. We may run the city now, but the Christians must still be allowed to worship as they see fit.
Seems the Red Hand disagrees.
What's more, Althon is worried they will come for the Archives next. Between this and all the uproar at the harbor, I would say we have some leads.
I'll get started at once. No, I need you here. Listen to the voices in this hall. Look for any signs, changes in behavior, anything.
I would swallow a horse heart to join you, Ibor.
I know, old friend. Your loyalty is why I need you here. I will return when I find something.
Einu sinni en dregi út járnspon var ég vandi að höggva 20 fyrir morgumat
Lúse í sonu Lúse eiru
The archives This must be where Alden shuffles the council papers
Thank you, Audi. I will leave with these at once.
Of course. A4, isn't it? What brings you to our archives?
I've come to ask about these Christian texts. Lufina tells me the Red Hand is stealing them.
And destroying them. I fear they will attack these archives next. The Abbess here has offered to bring the texts somewhere safe. She's been working diligently on this matter.
You flatter me, Lord. I only wish to help.
Abbess Ingeborg, this is Eivor, our honor guest from the south. Eivor has offered to help rid Jorvik of the Red Hand.
How can I help?
Hmm.
The Red Hand seems to know where to look for these texts. It may be someone is guiding them. What can you tell me? You know something else. That much is clear.
The Abbess has her suspicions.
As much as it pains me to say, I suspect something foul at the rectory. I have heard whispering, collusion, and the bishop. He has been sneaking around the rectory, often visiting the priests in the cover of night.
Time I pay these men of faith a visit.
The rectory is on the road to the minster. I should look for the bishop there. Wreaths, timber, food, wine. An expensive list of items to procure for a feast. A pile of official scrolls, stamped with a seal.
I have the Yuletide feast to prepare for as well. Do drop by for the festivities, A4. Have a drink or two.